Dr. Neil Spector is a cancer specialist at Duke University Medical Center. He developed a groundbreaking breast cancer drug and is a member of the Komen Scholars, an international group of leading cancer experts. But more than anything else, Spector is a survivor.
I started having these episodes of just transient rapid heart rates, palpitations. It's not uncommon for people to get that. You get a little anxious. But these would just come on without any provocation. And so, I'm a physician. I thought, this is not normal. And they just seemed frightening to me.
Unknown to him, he had been bitten by a tick that infected him with Lyme disease. But every time he sought medical attention, the symptoms would go away. Doctors kept telling him he was just under too much stress.
So I was driving down I-95 and started having every classic symptom of a heart attack. So, this pain that just crescendoed like an elephant sitting on my chest. The pain was radiating up into my jaws and down my left arm. And my wife was there, and I started telling her to tell everyone I knew, how much I love them, and, just preparing to die, and also trying to make it safely off of 95 and managed to get to an emergency room. And again, by the time I got there, things had resolved. They just said it must be stress. I knew that wasn't stress because I had worked, as a resident, 120 hours a week in a very stressful environment, inner city hospital in Dallas, and I'd never experienced symptoms like that.
4 years went by and no one could tell him what was wrong. They thought he might have multiple myeloma or an undefined heart problem. But the more Spector researched his symptoms, the more he suspected Lyme disease. But since he contracted the illness while living in Florida, where the disease is very rare, Spector was worried doctors there wouldn't recognize it or know how to treat it. So he had his test results sent to the Northeast, where Lyme disease is very common.
And so after 3 or 4 days, I got a call from the cardiologist who said, well, your test is negative. Now I just say, to me, when somebody, the head of cardiology, says your test is negative, I figure the test is negative. I didn't really understand at that time the controversy. I mean, it turns out my test was not negative. It just wasn't completely positive, by checking all the boxes. But, as we know, or at least in medicine, people don't fit into nice little boxes that you check off. I mean, everyone's a little different.
Spector says that is one of the most difficult things about Lyme disease. It is, as he calls it, a masquerader. It usually causes a bullseye rash around the bite, but not always. It often causes arthritis symptoms, but not always. And false negatives for Lyme disease tests are common.
And the tests are very confusing, and frankly, there needs to be more money spent on research. Lyme disease research is way down, on the totem pole of funding. And we just, we don't understand what's chronic. A lot of the medical profession thinks that it's psychosomatic, it's in their head. Well, you got treated, you should be fine. Well, they're not fine.
After relentlessly researching Lyme disease testing, he got tested yet again and was finally diagnosed in 1997. Still experiencing symptoms, Spector vowed to fight through it. He continued to work, to travel, to spend time with his family. But his heart continued to deteriorate. By the time he took a job as a cancer researcher at Duke, his heart only had 10% function. He received a pacemaker and a defibrillator. And in 2009, he entered what he calls his months of hell.
July 17th, I was in the intensive care unit at Memorial Hospital at UNC. I was in pretty extreme, dire situation, where I looked like I was about 6 months pregnant, just with fluid that had accumulated. My abdomen, was just massive. My kidney function was deteriorating. My liver function was deteriorating. I mean, essentially,
you were dying.
I was dying.
And then a surgeon came in with the ultimate bad news.
And he said, you're going to be dead by Monday. So this is Friday. He said, you're going to be dead by Monday, and you need to have a heart transplant.
He was rushed to Duke and placed on the top of the transplant list. And in only 36 hours, he had a new heart. Through it all, his wife fought with him to save his life.
She never cracked. I mean, I know in her own way it was just pure hell. But she never really showed any signs of that to me, thank God. You need a strong person by your side. You need somebody to go through an experience like this. I mean, 16 years was, it's not just the transplant, this was 16 years. So, she was amazing.
After the transplant, Spector continued his cancer research and wrote a book about his battle with Lyme disease. He's convinced he contracted it on a family trip to the Northeast. But a number of Lyme disease cases are contracted right here in North Carolina.
It has been reported in 78 of our state's 100 counties. And the worst months? May, June, and July.
Symptoms include fatigue, joint and muscle pain, and a bullseye rash. If left untreated, it can cause arthritis, back pain, vertigo, and infections in the brain, joints, and heart. Spector says if you suspect Lyme disease and your doctor doesn't, get a second opinion.
If you're afraid that your doctor is going to be upset with you for seeking a second opinion, you need a new doctor, frankly. You need to take health into your own hands, because no matter how compassionate and wonderful your physician is, no one cares about your life more than you do.
To prevent Lyme disease or any other tick-borne illness, wear long pants when you go into the woods. Tuck the pant legs into your socks so the ticks can't easily crawl up your legs. Wear insect repellent, and when you get home, check for ticks, not just on you, but your children and any pets. The tick that causes Lyme disease is called the black-legged tick or deer tick and is smaller than the more common dog tick. Lyme disease can be successfully treated with antibiotics, but as Spector knows, you have to recognize it to treat it.
If you feel that you're being told something that just doesn't jive with you, don't stop until you get an answer.
For 16 years, Neil Spector lived under a death sentence. At any time during his battle with Lyme disease, he could have dropped dead. Yet through a change of heart, both physically and emotionally, he survived and learned a very valuable life lesson in the process. You may have a disease, but it doesn't have you.
Enjoy your life. You have to take time to smell the roses, because your life can change literally in a heartbeat.